Hello, and welcome to another episode of the Verde Valley Experience. I'm your host, Jennifer Cohen. Thank you so much for joining us today. I know that it's gorgeous weather and you probably want to be outside, but maybe you're taking a break, you're just hanging out, maybe you're watching us on verdevalleytv.com, perhaps YouTube, who knows? You're sitting and watching TV in the air conditioning. It's all good. We really appreciate you watching. So we're right here in the thick of summer, is really getting going, and you know my favorite thing that happens every summer is July 4th. It is absolutely one of my favorite holidays, and in the town of Clarkdale, they do the old-fashioned 4th of July celebration. This is their 41st annual. Amazing how long they've been doing this. Well, we're going to have for our first guest, Joni Westcott, who's from the town of Clarkdale's Community Services and Parks and Rec Department. She's going to tell us about all the same things that we've come to love about the wonderful celebration with the fire trucks and the parade and all that. Plus, there's some new stuff this year, which is really exciting, and we're going to hear all about that in just a few. Then we'll meet with photographer Mike McClellan, and he's going to talk about taking your cell phone pictures to the next step. Perhaps you've thought about getting a DSLR camera, but you've been intimidated by all the manual settings. I know I have, total technophobe, so it freaks me out. Well, Mike's going to be here to explain the basics on how manual settings will let you take your photography skills to the next level, and you'll see he's got some beautiful examples of just how to do that. And this is so exciting. Sedona's two favorite festivals, Sedona Street Arts and Gumption Fest, have joined hands to create one huge event that's going to be happening throughout the summer, all the way starting now until October, every so many weekends, and it's going to be really awesome. Now, it's so amazing and incredible as far as a community street arts festivals goes, and it's totally just the most, you wouldn't believe who comes out of the woodwork for this festival. It's a free intergenerational event showcasing and celebrating arts, music, dance, live painting, crafting, skate competitions, fire dancing. Yes, I said fire dancing. At all things performance art. So you're going to want to check that out. Organizers Jason Vargo and Sierra Schaefer are with us. They're going to tell us what's happening throughout the summer as far as that goes. And then we'll go on location to the Camp Verde Public Library, and we'll speak with Library Director Kathy Hillman and also Zach Garcia, who is the teen librarian. He's so much fun. They're going to talk about the Discover NASA program, which is a really huge, amazing, big deal and an honor that's happening at the Camp Verde Library this summer. It's an interactive, all-ages exposition. It's an inside look at NASA, America's Space Agency. You can discover NASA in six different areas: human exploration, Earth science, Mars exploration, solar system and beyond, aeronautics and technology. Totally get ready to geek out at the Camp Verde Library if you've got anything you love about NASA. It was really cool, so you're going to want to stick around for that. And then we'll finish out our show today with August West. He's going to be rocking the house playing some of his favorites. He plays the Beatles, the Stones, Van Morrison, America, Simon and Garfunkel, Tom Petty, so many more of all my favorites. I know they're probably yours too, so make sure you stick around for that. We're going to go ahead and get started now. Our first guest today is the wonderful Joni Westcott, here from the town of Clarkdale Community Services and Parks and Rec Department.
Thank you so much for having me.
You're welcome. That's a fun section to work in. If you got to work for
it
a
is
town,
great.
That's a good one.
It is great.
Oh my gosh.
We have a good time.
I bet. And you're new to it.
Well, I'm not new to the department, but mm-hmm. new to the position. Yes, filling in for someone who left recently.
Sure.
So it's a good thing. I've been a part of the 4th of July event for many, many years mm-hmm. Living in Clarkdale, and been a part of the department to be able to take over the position.
Yeah.
And
that's
still,
wonderful.
Still pull it off.
You've got on-hand personal experience
yes.
of the parade.
Yes. Yes. My kids were in it for, 17 years, 18
wow.
years, something like that. Now my grandkids are in there,
oh,
so it's very fun.
Fantastic.
It's a great event.
It is a great event. For the first year last year, my daughter participated in the parade, and she wants to do it again this year.
Yeah.
So she's come out of her shyness, and it's so much fun to yeah. see the kids do the parade. But it's not just the parade. There's a lot going on that
right.
day, which is Tuesday, July 4th. It starts at mm-hmm. 7. Tell us what's going to mm-hmm. happen this year.
Well, we start with the pancake breakfast mm-hmm. with the fire department and police department sponsor that and put it on. We're also bringing back this year the ice cream social.
Mm.
And actually the Clarkdale Historical Society and Museum is sponsoring that. So it's a fundraiser for their organization.
All right.
And I know a lot of folks were upset that weren't able to offer it last year, and so it's really great that it's going to be back this year. We're really excited about that. And then we have some music. We've got games for the kids. It's hosted, sponsored by the Clarkdale Jerome School. And the parade, of course, mm-hmm. and then the community band, the Cottonwood Community
nice.
Band is the best, is the, everybody really looks forward to that.
Absolutely.
Piece. Participated for a long time.
Oh my gosh, yeah, it's a wonderful performance. People come out and they bring their chairs and we sit, and it brings up all the nostalgia of all the wonderful days gone by, and the hominess and the community, everyone sitting and enjoying a beautiful day in a beautiful mm-hmm. park, and of course the music is fabulous, and then you've got the pavilion there giving out mm-hmm. the awards for the kids.
Right, yeah, the mayor comes in and mm-hmm. does his thing, and gives out the awards for the parade winners.
Right.
So the parade they get awards for best pet, bicycle, most patriotic. Mm-hmm. There's several different awards, and people don't have to register ahead of time. They can actually just come at 8:15 that morning and sign up. And the parade starts at 9:00.
So there we go.
And actually just a little bit of history. I found this out from my family, who's been here for a long time. The very first parade was in 1975, and it was just a children's parade. They just went down Main Street and had a little parade, and then the next year they brought in the ice cream social, and it's just grown to be this huge event mm-hmm. for Clarkdale, and it's great for the residents, and we get a lot of out-of-town people as well that come for it.
Yeah. It's always quite a turnout.
Yes.
The street is lined beautifully, though I have to say, in case you're wondering, I've never had a problem parking. I love that.
Yeah, our parking is very unique for mm-hmm. the town. There does seem to be
beautifully
plenty
laid
for
out.
Everyone.
There's always mm-hmm. plenty of parking. So mm-hmm. come on down. There's plenty of parking. Bring the kids. Bring your chairs.
Right.
And one of the favorite things is the fire truck rides.
Right. The fire truck rides. So they start, let me tell you what time they start, actually. 7:30, the fire truck rides start from the corner of the park, and they the kids love it. And, lots of people get on, adults mm-hmm. and kids mm-hmm. can ride on the fire truck.
I know.
It's very fun.
Yep.
And
that poor fire truck must be so tired by the end of the day. Just driving in circles, that and Jay Kinsella was driving it for a few years. He must list to the right when he gets out of the fire truck from driving all day. But it's just so wonderful. It's just a great event. And that's
great
that you've got a fundraiser tied into it mm-hmm. now for mm-hmm. the one. I love the Clemenceau Museum. It's mm-hmm. just fantastic.
It's actually the Clarkdale Jerome or the Clarkdale Historical Society mm-hmm. Museum. It's right in Clarkdale.
Ah, very good.
And right next to our police department, actually, on 9th Street in Clarkdale, right near our complex.
Excellent. I have not been to that one.
Yeah, it's very cool. And the folks who work in there are very knowledgeable about the history of Clarkdale and of the town, of the Clarkdale town complex, the town offices mm-hmm. and buildings, our Clarkdale Clubhouse. Mm-hmm. They give a lot of information on that.
Oh, wow. See, I learned something new today. I didn't know about that museum.
And I also want to talk to you today about our concerts in the park.
Please do. Very excited.
Because we have a concert this Saturday mm-hmm. From 7 to 9 in the park, and it is Cadillac Angels, a mm-hmm. Very popular band. We usually have them every year. Mm-hmm. And so we're really excited about that. We have a whole concert series for the summer. You can go to our website at www.clarkdale.az.gov and check out all of the upcoming bands. They usually run about every other week.
So every other week.
Every other Saturday.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Every other Saturday.
Yes. That's,
it's a lot of fun. Again, beautiful park, gazebo, bring your chairs, bring your blankets, your mm-hmm. dogs, your kids, listen to some amazing music. That's a really wonderful program you guys have been running for a number of years now.
Yes, we have. Yeah.
How do you manage to do that? I mean, these guys don't play for free, so.
No, they don't. Well, some actually do, but it's just part of our the fundraising that we do mm-hmm. throughout the year, and that helps fund that event.
Giving back to the mm-hmm. community, and what a mm-hmm. great event. That park gets a lot of use.
Yes, it does.
That's really great.
Yeah,
and one of the fun things about the 4th of July parade is that it will be a live broadcast of it on from Verde Valley TV.
Right, you guys
will
be
doing
be
a broadcast of that, so you can watch it over again when you go home. You can watch it and there we are, and you can wave, and so you can kind of extend that wonderful nostalgic mm-hmm. feeling, and you can send it to grandma and all that stuff. So mm-hmm. everybody gets to feel like they're a part of this small town community.
Right,
and it always turns out so great.
Absolutely,
so great. Thank you for your involvement.
Thank
I'm glad
you.
That you've taken the wheel on this one.
Yes,
and it's going to
be awesome. Very good. And so again, for the concert in the park series, we want to go to your website to check out who's playing. And that is a free event.
Yes, absolutely. Absolute free event. We have 50-50 raffle, so people can win lots of money by participating in that. And that basically, it's our 50-50 raffle that actually helps us pay for the bands.
Excellent.
So
there we go.
That's great.
Very good. Make sure you participate. And of course, make sure you participate in the 4th of July celebration that's happening in the town of Clarkdale. Of course, that's Tuesday, July 4th from 7 until 11. Kids Parade starts at 9, but you need to get yourself registered in at 8:15
at the Clarkdale Jerome School.
There you go. And they start the awards about 10-ish, something like that.
Pancake breakfast. Actually,
10:30. Start with pancake breakfast with the firemen. Awesome. Get yourself a fire truck ride.
Meet us at the gazebo at 10:30 for awards.
Ice cream socials. Yeah. I mean, it's the best day of the year.
Yeah, absolutely.
Thank you, Joni.
Thank you so much for having me.
Joni Westcott, who is from the town of Clarkdale, Community Services, Parks and Rec Department. She's got a wonderful job. And we'll be right back, so don't go away.
The Q102.9 plays all the hits.
Yo, what's going on? This is Drizzy Drake.
Ariana Grande.
Maroon 5.
This is Rihanna.
I'm Mateo.
I'm Shawn Mendes.
Hey, it's Bruno Mars.
Ed Sheeran.
What's up, guys? It's Justin Bieber.
You're listening to The Weeknd.
I'm a star boy.
Start your day with Brian James in the morning. You'll get at least 10 songs in a row during your ride home with Julie Page.
Zach Sang Show.
Catch the Zach Sang Show weeknights 7 to midnight. And Kelly Fox weekends on your home for hit music. The Q102.9 and 104.9 in Prescott and Cottonwood.
Papa!
Miss Lee, this is Agent Williams from the tax office. Our records show an unpaid balance on your account. If you don't pay by end of day, you'll be facing jail time. Well, the fastest way to fix this is with a prepaid debit card. Can you go get one now? Yes, and we want to clear this up. If you just buy that prepaid card, put $400 on it, then call me back and read the numbers to me.
The moment they ask for a prepaid card is the moment you know something's wrong. Think before you send money. Learn more at scamawareness.org.
And welcome back to the Verde Valley Experience. We are now joined by photographer Mike McClellan. Now, you've got to look this gentleman up. His photography is amazing. I don't know how you do what you do, Mike, but it's gorgeous.
I don't either.
You don't either?
I just take a picture.
Well, I heard, a little birdie told me this was a childhood passion of yours.
Yeah, it started. I was a little kid running around with a little camera, just filming everything. I was kind of obsessed with it.
Understandable. And you grew up in Jerome, so what better palette is there?
It was an interesting place. Interesting time. Yeah.
Everywhere you look, it's so picturesque up there. So it's a good place to start.
That definitely helps. And when you're filming around here, Jerome or Sedona, you really got to try to get a bad picture.
That's true. Between the light and the subject matter, we have an abundance of opportunities to take photos here.
Yeah, and it's very inspiring. It gets you out of the house, which is kind of nice thing about
absolutely.
It.
Out and into nature. So here you go. Nice low impact activity for you. Go out and take pictures. You know, everybody's got their cell phones and their iPhones and all that, and you can manage to take a pretty good picture with one of those these days. But, you know, it's not quite the art quality that maybe some folks are ready to jump into. So what would you suggest for folks who've been, you know, hanging out with their phone for a while and they're like, man, I really want to create something.
Sure. Well, the phone, it can do a lot. It can do great pictures. And most of the times it works when you just need something light and quick little picture. But if you want to turn it to art, you really want to get serious about it, you need to upgrade to DSLR. And from there, you will start learning about the settings that the auto is doing for you. But the auto doesn't know what you're doing. It's just an algorithm trying to get the best picture, but it doesn't know what you're going for. So when you learn to manipulate the settings on your own, you really can get stuff that you just can't do with a cell phone. For example, like if you want to do a long exposure, if you've seen some of the pictures where there's a car light just kind of going through, or you're in the middle of the day and it's a river, but it looks like silky smooth, you have to do long exposures where your shutter is open for a long time. So to do that, you've got to learn to manipulate the three settings. So the basics, just kind of give a low rundown for anybody that is interested in taking that next step. You've got three things that are involved with your exposures. You've got your ISO, which is your sensitivity to light, whether it's film or your sensor in the camera. So if you got a ton of light kind of shining in, like these lights here onto a sensor, you want it to be a lower ISO to where it doesn't react as much to light. Where at night, you don't have much light, you want it to be very reactive. Mm-hmm. The side effect of higher ISO is film noise. So you can't go too high. So if you go up to above 1600, it's going to start getting pretty noisy. So you have to manipulate. If you're outside, you want to go 100 less noise, least amount of noise. So you always manipulate to the lowest ISO you can, so you don't get that film noise.
Film noise. Explain that. I've never heard that before.
So on the film, so you've got this chemical reaction taking when the light comes in the center and it hits that film. So if it's very, if it's a high ISO for nighttime, it's going to react to any little bit of light. So if you have a ton of light, it's just going to overexpose and blow out. So that's why in the daytime you lose like an ISO 100, so it doesn't react very much. But a higher one, like a 1600, it doesn't take much. So any bit of light, even if it's not enough to really cause an exposure, can get a reaction on that film. So it'll look like these little dots in the shadow. And you can clean that up in your post and stuff like that, but generally you don't want it. So But your auto doesn't know that. It might throw it up to 32 because it's trying to get exposure. Now you got a really noisy image. So so the next one would be your f-stop, your aperture. People ever heard of f2, things like that? So your f-stop's like your pupil on your eyelid. Ton of light shines in, your pupil's going to restrict to kind of limit it. Dark, it's going to kind of dilate. Same thing with the f-stop. So an f2 is very wide, so it's going to let a lot of light in. So if you're in a very dark place, you want a very wide aperture like an f2 as opposed to like an f22. The effect of the f-stop is the f2 is going to create this very, very, very shallow depth of field. So you've ever seen that shot where just the eyes are in focus, but everything else kind of falls out of focus? So you're using a very big f-stop, like an f2, where f22, everything's going to be focused. So that's a matter of taste, what it is you're looking for. And then you've got your shutter speed, which is like, I don't know, use the analogy of your eye blinking. So if you blink super fast, everything's frozen in time. If you blink real slow, you captured all that movement. And when you're putting it onto film, it's going to be blurry. So if you're doing something where people are moving or things like that, you need a fast aperture. I mean, shutter speed, open and closed. But that also affects your exposure. The longer it's open, the more light gets in. So these are the three things you're going to be trying. First thing I would suggest is pick your priority. If it's sports, if it's motion, and you need something really fast, you're going to pick the right shutter speed for that to capture that. Then you're going to go start, you know, tinkering with your f-stops and stuff like that. So that would be the main thing.
Well, there you go. Pick your subject matter. If it's a flower, it's not really moving. But if it's your son playing baseball, it's something totally different.
And that flower being still, you can have that aperture open for a long time, so you can kind of tweak around that. So then that would probably be your f-stop would be your priority, your aperture priority, to get that really narrow depth of field. So you set that in f2. Now you check, okay, it's overexposed. Well, let me drop down the ISO and
there you go. Photography has come such a long way since when I was a kid and my dad carried around this enormous camera with all these different things. And now you can do so much with computer programs, and you can just make amazing things out of almost anything. But of course, if you take a good photo to begin with, it makes it a whole lot easier.
What you're working with does help.
It does. It makes a whole lot of difference. And like I say, your photography is wonderful. I find it on the internet and it's really, really great. And your landscapes are really, really amazing. And of course, in this area, you can get a wonderful, wonderful thing. So this guy knows what he's talking about, so you better be listening.
Stop some more.
So you've done such a wonderful job of explaining. You know, you've narrowed it down to three things that are really, really important, because most people get really like me, technophobe, like brain starts to scramble. So just think of those three things and you're good to go as far as getting started.
Yeah, and it's, you know, I studied way before digital, because you don't know how far things have come along. And when I went to film school, there wasn't such thing as digital. And if you're going to edit, there's these huge editing machines, not a laptop in your house. So we do have the ability to do so much for so cheap now. It's like you've got to take advantage of
that. That's true. Of course, if you need a good photographer too, you know where to find him. Mike, thank you so much for joining us today. I really appreciate it. What project are you working on right now, real quick?
My brother just had a wedding.
All right.
And so I'm making a wedding video for
nice.
Him. So I'm working on editing that.
Well, congratulations to your brother.
I appreciate it.
Oh, very cool. Thank you for being here. Mike McClellan, who is a photographer, most amazing, from Jerome. Great stuff. Check him out on the internet. And don't go away, because we've got lots more of The Experience coming at you.
The Q102.9 plays all the hits.
Yo, what's going on? This is Drizzy Drake.
Ariana Grande.
Maroon 5.
This is Rihanna.
I'm Mateo.
I'm Shawn Mendes.
Hey, it's Bruno Mars.
Ed Sheeran.
What's up, guys? It's Justin Bieber.
You're listening to The Weeknd. I'm a
starboy. Start your day with Brian James in the morning. You'll get at least 10 songs in a row during your ride home with Julie Page.
Zach Sang Show.
Catch the Zach Sang Show weeknights 7 to midnight. And Kelly Fox weekends on your home for hit music. The Q102.9 and 104.9 in Prescott and Cottonwood.
Orkin has pest control down to a science.
When your business chooses Orkin's Precision Protection Program, you get a tailored pest control program for your specific industry and environment.
Your business can benefit from over a century of experience, training, and scientific knowledge that define the Orkin man.
Maximum protection, minimum exposure, backed by one of the industry's most comprehensive guarantees.
Choose your locally owned and operated Northern Arizona Orkin and get more than an exterminator. Get an expert.
And welcome back to the Verde Valley Experience. We are now here with Jason Vargo and Sierra Schaefer, and we are talking about the Gumption Street Arts Festival. The 8th. Well, it's now, can we call this an 8th annual since it's now two things mushed into one, or is it its own entity now? Do we need to start over?
It's number one, but it's got a history associated with it.
That's an excellent way to put it, Jason. Yeah. Yes, it does have a history. Tell us a little bit about the history of Gumption Fest here in Sedona.
Well, I guess we can start with the Gumption Fest because it's kind of the longest history. It will actually be the 10th incarnation of Gumption Fest. We did 9 full years consecutively, and then we've been on hiatus for a couple of years. It started out as just a grassroots festival that a group of friends created together, so they had an opportunity to have a platform to share all of the art that they were doing, you know, together. You know, you had artists and dancers and musicians and poets and visual artists and, you know, all of these people that were just, you know, hanging out doing their thing. And then we made a festival so we could get out and do our thing, you know, all together.
Great.
So it was a really neat thing. We started, I think, in 2006. Mm-hmm. And but then it went on hiatus because it's just after doing something for so long.
Sure.
You know, sometimes you need a break. And
absolutely.
Then there was the Sedona Street Arts Fest.
Right, yes.
That came up.
So while Gumption Fest was on hiatus, we came up with Sedona Street Arts Festival through Red Earth Theater, which runs the Sedona Posse Grounds Hub, which was a teen center that not much was happening there. Mm-hmm. It's right by the skate park, right by Sedona Posse Grounds Park. So then Kate Hawks was like, let's do the Sedona Street Arts Festival and some other creators as well. And we've done 3 of them last year in the summer. And that was while Gumption, and it's very similar theme to Gumption. Mm-hmm. The theme of Sedona Street Arts Festival was view and do. So you come out and you watch live art in the making, and you get to participate hands-on in painting. We had a person with clay. We have a hip-hop dance workshop. They're coming back. The Sacred G's from Phoenix are coming back. So we have workshops available for people to just come and experience different forms of art and to express themselves in art they're already doing, and then to inspire other people to go out and make art. Like last year, when I went home, I got my paints out again. You know,
right.
I just was really inspired. There's a community mural. it's intergenerational. Mm-hmm. So we've smushed our festivals together because the themes go really, really well together. So why not?
No, they're perfectly complementary.
Yeah, and so we've made, now we're calling it Gumption Street Arts Festival, or GSAF for short. Mm-hmm. And we have a Facebook group if you want to stay up to date with all of the events, because it's happening four times this year and ongoing. Even if one of us were to leave, whatever, it's going to keep going.
Yeah.
And it'll
stay alive at this point.
Yeah, so Gumption Street Arts Festival on Facebook.
There you go.
Is a group that you can totally connect with and get
it's
involved
a great
in the
Facebook
community.
Page. Yep, I love it. It's got all the information you need. Mm-hmm. Now, coming up, we have a festival that's going to be happening on the 24th through the 25th. So that weekend, it's like these great weekends of just art and festivities that are just wonderful. Mm-hmm. So this is the next one coming up, but it's not the only one, because you have another one and another all the way until October.
Right, there's a series throughout the summer. Yeah.
Right, it's a summer series, which is too much fun. You don't find that in certain festivals. You
right.
say one and done. Mm-hmm. And you're like, oh, that was great, I have to wait till next year. But not so with the Gumption Street Arts Fest.
We're also doing our best to make it town-wide. We have several locations.
Yep, that's right.
So.
So it's centered, you know, we'll have the daytime festivities happening at the Posse Grounds, as Sierra explained. Mm-hmm. The brand new Barbara's Park Pavilion.
Yes.
This beautiful amphitheater in Sedona, outdoors. It's amazing. So that will be where most of the music is happening all day on Saturday. There will be also, like you said, the interactive art, you know, mural painting, vendors, food trucks. Mm-hmm. All sorts of stuff happening, you know, in very close walking distance over at the Hub, with the skate park in between, of course, with stuff going on in there.
A skate competition. Ooh. So bring your skateboards.
That's right.
Yeah. You don't want me to bring my skateboards.
I won't be skating either.
Maybe you'll involve yourself with something else.
Yeah.
You know, there's plenty of interactive stuff. You know, bring your gumption and figure out what you're going to do there.
Exactly.
Doesn't have to be on a skateboard.
And also bring your blankets and chairs and whatever and set on the grass all day.
But,
you know, bring your setup to be at a festival. Bring your party, you know.
Yeah.
It's alcohol and drug free until the brewery night, Saturday night.
Right. Which is where things go, to the Oak Creek Brewery over on Yavapai Drive.
Yes. Fun place.
Yeah.
Fun place.
Yeah,
great place to host a venue. The outside area is really nice.
And they've been super supportive of Gumption Fest ever since the beginning, you know, so we're really happy to be partnering with them again, too.
I bet. There's so much jammed into all of this. It's really exciting. And I love hip-hop, so that's kind of fun.
They're amazing, the dancers. They were just at Lightning in a Bottle, too. So they're like a cool, they're really fun. They're coming up from Phoenix, you know. They do two workshops. That's Sunday morning. So then Saturday morning, Heather Sheree Titus from Sedona Yoga Festival is coming, and we're going to kick off the whole thing with some yoga, which would be great for us coordinators who've been like working really hard, and all the people involved. There's a lot. We have a huge crew of people putting this on, so it's really nice, the community coming together and just, you know, for the cause of art.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Now, is there an admission fee for the weekend? Can you buy a pass? How does that work?
No, it's a free offering.
It's free.
You know, I'm not sure how the Street Arts Fest was, but we've always done Gumption Fest as a free, you know, by the people, for the people kind of thing. You know, it was always a volunteer sort of thing. So,
completely
just
free.
A celebration.
But it's put on by a nonprofit, so that's part of why it's. I mean, now it's under the umbrella of Red Earth Theater Company, and APS gave us a very substantial grant.
Yeah, we've had a lot of support too. You know, also the Friends of the Posse Grounds, the people that, you know, held the torch for well over a decade to have the Barbara's Park Pavilion actually come true, you know, from the vision that it was so long ago. Gumption Fest was actually an original supporter of the Barber's Park. We were one of the first people to, you know, donate some money to it. So it's this cool full circle thing that's happened, but they were very generous, you know, as well, to help this to happen. So
absolutely. Yeah, definitely something for everyone, because yoga and hip hop.
Sure, and everything in between.
And then fire dancing and hula hoops. What's with the hula hoops?
Yeah. We had hula hoops donated to us. We had like 20 hula hoops, and I can't remember her name, Jaguar Mary. She left town and she left us 20 hula hoops, and now we have a hula hooper coming who's going to perform and hopefully show us some things, because we have all these hula hoops that were donated.
Too fun.
So it's just kind of growing and snowballing as the more community gets involved, and that's what's fun about having multiple events throughout the year and having it being ongoing, is our contact list is just growing of artists in the community and coming up from Phoenix and Flagstaff. You know, we have different, last year it was the fire group was from Flagstaff.
Right.
And this year it'll be the group that's meeting every Thursday at Posse Grounds Hub.
Great.
So it's, you know, a whole hodgepodge of amazing people, and it's just a growing arts community.
Definitely. Well, good for you guys getting together and making this happen. Taking the two festivals, making it one.
What festival will we tumble into next?
Yeah, right.
I know. Well, our name's going to get really long.
It is.
Right.
True.
Exactly. No, it makes itself. The whole idea is it creates itself. You know, the people that come forward, you know, that have the gumption or who are a part of the community, they come together and create the whole thing with what they bring.
That's
so
great. Jason, thank you for being here, and thank you for what
you're
doing there.
And
Sierra, thank you so much, and thank you for getting together, and I look very much forward to it. The next one is happening June 24th through the 25th, Sedona Posse Grounds at the Hub. Check it out. Gumption Street Arts Festival. And we'll be right back, so don't go away.
What's going on? This is Drizzy Drake.
Ariana Grande.
Maroon 5.
This is Rihanna.
I'm Adele.
I'm Shawn Mendes.
Hey, it's Bruno Mars.
Ed Sheeran.
What's up, guys? It's Justin Bieber.
You're listening to The Weeknd.
I'm a star.
Start your day with Brian James in the morning. You'll get at least 10 songs in a row during your ride home with Julie Page.
Zach Sang Show.
Catch the Zach Sang Show weeknights 7 to midnight. And Kelly Fox weekends on your home for hit music. The Q 102.9 and 104.9 in Prescott and Cottonwood.
Did you know dragging chains can spark a wildfire?
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Papa!
Miss Lee, this is Agent Williams from the tax office. Our records show an unpaid balance on your account. If you don't pay by end of day, you'll be facing jail time. Well, the fastest way to fix this is with a prepaid debit card. Can you go get one now? Yes, and we want to clear this up. If you just buy that prepaid card, put $400 on it, then call me back and read the numbers to me.
The moment they ask for a prepaid card is the moment you know something's wrong. Think before you send money. Learn more at scamawareness.org.
Welcome back to the Verde Valley Experience. We are now here in the gorgeous Camp Verde Public Library. I'm standing here with Kathy Hillman, who is the library director, and we have Zach Garcia, who is the teen librarian, and they have a wonderful thing going on now till through July called Discover NASA from Our Town to Outer Space. How cool is this program?
It is really cool, especially since we're only one of 8 libraries in the nation to host this exhibit.
Wow.
So it was a grant-funded program. We were selected the only library in the state of Arizona to host it. So we're very excited about that.
That's
to be
amazing.
Able to bring this to a rural community that, you know, how far is it to drive to a science museum in Arizona from Camp Verde?
Right. Now what exactly goes on with the Discover NASA program?
There are about 12 kiosks throughout the library. They're interactive for kids to learn about NASA and space, especially Mars and the Mars rover. Mm-hmm. There's one in the back room back there where kids can pretend to announce the weather from Pluto or Neptune.
Or,
it has a green screen behind them, so their parents can record it on their phone while they're doing it if they want.
It's
a lot of. And then in addition to that, we have a lot of programming planned to enhance the exhibit or to go along with it. There's 3 very reputable presenters. Dr. Mm-hmm. Nadine Barlow from NAU will be talking about water on Mars.
Wow.
And Dr. Ken Zoll will be talking about the first meteorite man in Arizona. Mm-hmm. And Dr. Jeff Hall from the Lowell Observatory, he's the director there, will be talking about sunspots on the sun and how that affects the climate we experience. So that's for the adults. And then we have programs every Friday for children. We're doing STEAM time, but it's all Discover NASA themed STEAM time.
Right.
So we have a couple star parties planned. The kids are going to make telescopes one STEAM time, and then they're going to get to use them out here on our third balcony, third
neat.
Level balcony. So, yeah, a lot of programs for kids and adults both.
Yeah, and it's wonderful all around the library. There's all these wonderful banners, and there's interactive kiosks. You've got several things that you sit and, you know, it does stuff. Mm-hmm. And it, there's a lot going on in here. You could probably spend about 2 hours before you actually get to see it all.
Yeah. And last week we had a space camp, and the kids got to go through different stations and learn different aspects of space and what it might be like to be an astronaut or a space cadet. So
that's true.
They can spend time at every kiosk. It's part of our summer reading program too, and so they get extra points for all of the different activities they do towards summer reading.
Very, very nice.
Yeah, so.
And this goes on until the end of July.
It does, yes.
Which is wonderful. And so the hours are library hours,
exactly.
As far as coming in and doing the exhibits. Uh-huh. And for the special speakers, are they on a specific date? They're on Fridays?
They are on different dates.
Different dates.
The best thing to do is look at our website.
Absolutely.
Yep.
And the website?
It's www.cvlibrary.org.
There you go.
The thing is, some things have changed.
Of course.
You know, we put out this brochure pretty early, but some of the things in it have already changed. So
there
the best
go.
Thing to do is look at the website.
As they say, please listen carefully as menu items may change.
Exactly. Yep.
So we understand that.
Yeah.
Now, speaking of the perspective of an astronaut, you have a very interesting program here, which Zach is involved in as the teen librarian. And tell me, I'm going to get the name wrong, Zach. So tell me, it's called the Oculus
Rift.
Okay, so tell us about that.
Oculus Rift is a virtual reality headset, and with it you can experience what it's like to be an astronaut. So we've got a program that is basically a virtual reality tour of the International Space Station.
Get out.
So you put on the headset, and it's like you are in the space station. When you look up and down and around, it's what the astronauts would actually see. And then there's two little hand controls that also interact, so you can interact with different things that would be found around the space station. It was open to teens only at first with the teen library, and it was part of our kickoff for the summer reading program. But now it's open to everybody, as long as you come and check in at the front desk, because the teen library is 12 to 17 only, but we are going to let other people experience this, because it's on loan from the state library, and it's a pretty high-tech piece of equipment, and not everybody has access to one.
It's amazing.
So we want to make it available to everybody while we have it.
That's too cool. Virtual reality of being like in the space station and an astronaut. That has to be, have you tried it? You must have tried it.
I've tried it, and it's pretty cool. When you're in it, it's like seeing is believing. You really believe that you can reach out and touch everything that's there.
That is way too cool. So you want to firsthand experience the space station. You've got to come and participate in the Oculus Rift. Now, are there times that that's available, or is it just during library hours any day?
During library hours, as long as myself or the clerk is at the desk.
Oh, excellent, excellent, excellent. And you mentioned it was part, you've worked it into your summer reading program. How did you do that?
So we did it for the space camp kickoff of our summer reading program. Mm-hmm. So the kids that came and experienced it on the first day got points for it for summer reading. Summer reading, 1 minute of reading is worth 1 point, but every event that they come to is worth 100 points. So the target goal is 1,600 points by the end of summer reading, which is, it goes through July. And we've got lots of different activities all through the summer. My activities for the teens are every Friday. And the theme of summer reading program is Build a Better World. So we're building bat houses for Ozonical Park. We're building lamps for the stacks where it's dark in the library. We're gonna build a playhouse for the Children's Library's courthouse. So lots of building things.
Wow, that is just too cool. There is a lot going on at the Camp Verde Library this summer. So make sure you check out cvlibrary.org. You have to make sure you come in during this time. Don't miss it. There's too many things going on in here between their programs, their Friday nights, their Thursday nights. They got lots of stuff going on. Check out cvlibrary.org and don't go away because we'll be right back.
Q102.9 plays all the hits.
Yo, what's going on? This is Drizzy Drake.
Ariana Grande.
Maroon 5.
This is Rihanna.
I'm Adele.
I'm Shawn Mendes.
Hey, it's Bruno Mars.
Ed Sheeran.
What's up, guys? It's Justin Bieber.
You're listening to The Weeknd. I'm a
star. Start your day with Brian James in the morning. You'll get at least 10 songs in a row during your ride home with Julie Page.
Zach Sang Show.
Catch the Zach Sang Show weeknights 7 to midnight. And Kelly Fox weekends on your home for hit music. The Q102.9 and 104.9 in Prescott and Cottonwood.
Did you know parking over tall, dry grass can spark a wildfire?
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Papa!
Miss Lee, this is Agent Williams from the tax office. Our records show an unpaid balance on your account. If you don't pay by end of day, you'll be facing jail time. Well, the fastest way to fix this is with a prepaid debit card. Can you go get one now? Yes, and we want to clear this up. If you just buy that prepaid card, put $400 on it, then call me back and read the numbers to me.
The moment they ask for a prepaid card is the moment you know something's wrong. Think before you send money. Learn more at scamawareness.org.
I seen Jesus play with flames in the lake of fire I was standing in. Met the devil in Seattle. I spent 9 months inside the lion's den. I met Booty at another time. Showed me a glowing light within. But I swear that God is there every time I look into the eyes of my best friend. Said, my son, it all been done. Someday you'll wake up old and gray. Go now and have some fun. Show some warmth to everyone. You meet and greet and cheat along the way. There's a gateway in our minds that leads us out there somewhere far beyond this plane. Where reptile aliens made a light, cut you open and pull out all your pain. Tell me how you make illegal something that we all make in our brain. Some say you might go crazy, then again it might make you go sane. Every time I take a look inside that old and fabled book, I'm blinded and reminded by the pain caused by some old man in the sky. Marijuana, LSD, psilocybin, DMT, they all change the way I see, and love's the only thing that ever saved my life. So don't waste your time on nursery rhymes, fairy tales of blood and wine. It's turtles on the way down the line. So to each we go into our home. Other realms our souls must roam. Through and through the myth we all call space and time.
That was wonderful.
I
loved that. August West, everyone. Well, who sung that one? Who wrote
Sturgill
that one?
Simpson.
Ah, because I knew it sounded familiar, but I couldn't place it.
Yeah, he's hot as a firecracker right now.
Yeah, that's amazing. The lyrics in that are so
haunting.
Cool.
Haunting, yeah.
Yeah. Now, you like a lot of the same music. In fact, you like all the same music that I do. Music that I would kind of classify as Americana, even though not all the artists are originally from the United States.
Absolutely.
But it is, when we think of, you know, American and roots and stuff, mm-hmm. it comes up with the Stones. Even the Beatles are included in that.
Well, that's American music coming back to America, because mm-hmm. that was all roots music. Hill music and gospel and jazz and blues all kind of made their way through Elvis to England, came back as the Beatles and the Stones.
Right. Yeah. And it was a great time in music, and thank you for bringing it back.
Absolutely.
And keeping it alive. And you do such a great job. You really embody that, and your voice is perfect, and you're playing. It's great. You've been doing this a little while.
Long time. Yeah, long time. Long time lover of music. I've been blessed. Everybody, everywhere I go, everywhere I play, people seem to connect to the songs, and that's really gratifying.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. When you enjoy your job, it's very gratifying.
Yeah, you don't work a day in life.
Yeah, absolutely. Hey, I want to be a musician, too. You know, when I grow up, that's what I want to be.
Yep, that was on the list.
Absolutely. Now, you moved here from Florida, correct?
Mm-hmm.
How long have you been here now?
About 3.5 years
in
the Verde Valley. Moved to Sedona. My wife came out here about 6 months before I did, mm-hmm. and got us established and everything. And then,
got a good wife.
It was turnkey. Came out here and started gigging. Yeah,
that's awesome. Now you play at Vino de Sedona every third Wednesday.
Every third Wednesday at Vino, and then I play at Mooney's Irish Pub in Sedona a lot. I play there usually Fridays and Saturdays, 4 times a month.
So
play there a lot.
Yeah,
I'll be playing in Phoenix, Prescott. I play up in Flag at various venues up there. So it keeps me busy.
Yeah.
Keeps me busy.
I'll say keeps you playing. And you mentioned earlier, you will play 3 hours straight.
3 hours straight, yep.
Wow.
Yeah, no breaks.
How do you do that? Caffeine?
Beer?
Okay, hey, whatever works for you.
Right.
I mean, but that's impressive.
Yeah.
That's a sign of true talent. If you can just play that long.
Yep. People told me, you got to take your breaks. All the musicians told me, mm-hmm. you know, come here, take your breaks. And as soon as I did that, I build up a crowd, take a break, and then everybody left.
Exactly.
They go to the next bar.
Right.
So I said, no, we're just going to keep the party going, keep the people in their seats, and we'll make this the party
Absolutely.
Destination.
Absolutely. Keep the momentum going, because, you know, that drives me bananas. When I go see an artist, they take a break, and boom, the
And I usually get there during their last song. And then
they take a break.
Right.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's a wonderful thing to look forward to. When you go see August West, you don't have to worry about him taking a break.
Nope. And I take lots of requests.
Because
people, I love to do that, because people, they are celebrating or something. It's Sedona's a very destination tourism, so people are celebrating an anniversary, birthday, and then there's always a song that it means a lot to them, so they'll ask me, and I know like 1,000 songs. So
I was just about to say, I think you do know about 1,000 songs.
Yeah, I know a ton, so I always try to honor that for
That's
them.
Great.
Yeah.
And the fact that you know around 1,000 songs,
mm-hmm.
and yet you just pull them right out of your head, can't you?
Yeah. Well, I use technology, too, because sometimes when you know so many songs, you just can't think of what to play next. I have my laptop, which has like them all loaded, so I can just, okay, this song's appropriate now. I'll just load that up. So
nice.
Yeah, and plus I can't remember every word.
Well, yeah, you know.
So
you
I usually
paraphrase a little bit.
Exactly.
Well, we can't tell what half the lyrics are anyway in most songs. So.
I've done that. I've slurred a few, rounded them off, and said.
We've all done that.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
But that's the fun. See, what I like about you is you're very down to earth. You're very friendly. You're very approachable. You play the great music, and you play it well, and you love engaging the audience.
Yep.
So it's a fun.
Yep.
It's a fun concert.
Yep. It's that's the whole thing. That's what drives me. I want it to be fun. I don't want to be aloof. I don't want to be standoffish. Unfortunately, when I was younger, a lot of the guys that were in my town that were really good players were and I didn't want to be that way. So I wanted to be hugs and
yeah, the people's musician.
Yeah, yeah,
absolutely.
Totally.
You know, everybody's friend. I mean, it's a wonderful event.
Yep.
And you play so much. There's no excuse to not go and find August somewhere.
Nope. You'll find me everywhere.
Yep. Now you have a little bit of a Facebook page.
Yeah, yeah.
Just a little.
Yeah, tiny one.
Tiny one. And you gotta get your wife. You're starting to get on your Facebook page now.
Yeah,
mission that up a little bit and putting on the events, like where can we can see you next.
Yeah, that's phase two. But if you're in Sedona, you probably already know me and can catch me at a lot of places. The Oak Creek Brewery, I play there a lot as well.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
My friends up in Flagstaff, we play at the Flag Brew, Hops on Birch, the McMillan, the Monte V Lounge. And so I'll be playing at those venues as well coming up in the fall.
Nice.
Yep.
And keeping busy.
Staying busy.
Just keeping busy.
Yep.
And that's the plan for the future. Just keep busy, keep playing all over the place, all over the valley.
It is. It is. I'm putting a new band together right now.
All right.
So we're going to be playing in Phoenix and Prescott. We're going to start opening up in that market. It's going to be like Waylon Jennings, Willie Nelson, Johnny Cash.
Right on.
Some real honky tonkers.
All right.
And then my Grateful Dead band will be playing in Sedona.
Yes.
In Flag, back at the Orpheum. Yeah.
Right. The Grateful Dead band, which is called
American Beauty.
American Beauty.
Yep.
See, now there are a lot of Grateful Dead fans out there.
Yeah,
and I bet you do that so well.
We do. We do. We have a lot of fun with it. And hopefully we'll be playing soon. We have a new guitar player that just is joining the band. So we got to rehearse a couple times and then we'll be back at it.
Right on.
I think next month. July 7th at the Oak Creek Brewery, American Beauty will be playing.
All right, the Grateful Dead Band. Yep. That's amazing. Now the new band that you're starting.
New band's hot.
Because nobody ever just has one band. They got to have like five.
Yep.
So what's the new one called?
Well, it's unnamed yet. It's still an unnamed project. But it's really cool. We're going to have my friend Don Witcher is going to be playing the lap steel guitar.
Oh, he's amazing. Hi, Don.
Don's amazing. And then my friends from American Beauty, Michael Drew and Ivan Leibowitz, with playing bass and drums.
All right.
And then we're going to start as a quartet, possibly adding an organ from my friend Chade up in Flagstaff.
All right.
And then, we'll be throwing some serious jam band style honky tonk music going down.
Honky tonk.
So it's going to be, it's going to be, get your boots on, because you'll be dancing all night.
Jeez. Well, don't have any fun with any of this, okay? It doesn't look like you're enjoying yourself at all.
Right.
So, you know.
Yeah, I'm blessed. I'm blessed. I live a blessed life. I'm happy.
That's absolutely great. What made you decide to move here from Florida?
Well, Florida was, I've been there 17 years. Jimmy Buffett catalog was getting a little thin, and it was time to, and I really wanted to come out west and see the big sky country and see the canyons and the rivers and just see something different, a different climate. And I've been talking about it for years. My wife and I both talked about it for years, and then we pulled the trigger. We just said, time is now, let's do it.
Great.
So here we are.
Great. Well, we're blessed to have you here in the Verde Valley. Amazing musician and another band coming on the way.
Yep.
That'd be exciting.
Yep.
You need to have a little jar and little pieces of paper. People can write what they think your name should be. Wouldn't that be fun?
Yeah, a little contest.
That could be fun. Yeah, you never know. And then they win the first T-shirt.
Yeah,
you know, or
absolutely.
Something, you know. That's, you know, band names are so important.
They are.
They really are.
It might just be the August West band, but I don't know. They might be a little presumptuous.
No, there's nothing wrong with that. You definitely deserve that. Thank you so much for being on the show.
My pleasure.
Thank you for what you're doing and playing and your enthusiasm. And you're just such a nice guy.
Thanks a lot.
You know, isn't that nice to meet a nice musician? Not pretentious, not aloof, very nice, huggable. Yeah,
you're
right. Maybe you should call it the Huggable Band. What are you going to play for us next?
I'm going to play a little Greg Almond music since he passed away. He's one of my heroes, and this is called Sweet Melissa.
That's one of my favorites.
Yeah.
That's one of my favorites, so thank you. Thank you very much. August West, everyone. Make sure you check him out on Facebook. You can check him out at Vino, at Oak Creek Brewery, up in Flag. The guy's all over the place. If you happen to go as far out as Phoenix, you can do that too. Of course, you can check us out at verdevalleytv.com, also on YouTube. And we will see you next time. Thank you so much for watching the Verde Valley Experience.
Crossroads seem to come and go, gypsy flies from coast to coast, knowing many, loving none. and sorrow, having fun. But back home he always runs for sweet Melissa. Freight train, each car looks the same, all the same. And no one knows that gypsy's name. And no one hears his lonely sigh. There are no blankets where he lies. In his deepest dream, that gypsy flies with sweet Melissa. Again the morning comes, again he's on the run. Sunbeams shining through his hair, appear not to have a care, Lord. Well, pick up your gear and gypsy, roll on, roll on. Crossroads, will you ever let him go? Will you hide the dead man's gold? Or will he lie beneath that clay? Will his spirit roll away? But I know he won't stay without Melissa. Yes, I know he won't stay without Melissa.